Hey everyone, it's Jamie here and welcome to the Leonardo Royal Hotel, Southampton. Cruise enthusiasts often say to me they remember this hotel under previous management being a little run down. So we are back. What is it like now?
So we have a bog standard double room. It's a king size bed, no view to speak of, and it's cost £80 on a Friday evening. That's for the two of us. Let's go and have a look and see what it's like.
Alrighty, out of the lift, turn to the right, and it's just a few doors down, 104. Best check I've got the right one. Yes. Room card. There you go. And let's have a peep. Come in, you are very, very welcome. Alrighty, of note then, as you come in, to the left we've got the bathroom, we'll check that out later. On the right we've got storage space, we'll check that out later. I don't know why I'm whispering. Now, as you come in as well, you have a good size mirror. Check yourself out, we're looking alright. Hi everybody. As you come into the bedroom, look, my first impressions of this standard room is that it's actually quite a good size, very tidy looking, very contemporary as well. I have had a lot of questions over the last couple of years about this particular hotel. It used to go by a different name and it was in desperate need, I think, of a refurb. It has had that since the pandemic. And I don't think people realise that it's actually a lot nicer now, I believe, than it used to be. So just have a quick pan around of the room. This is a standard room and I think this is actually a very good size. So blue is my favourite colour, in case you were wondering. So I love the accent wall. Now, either side of this king bed, we do have bedside tables, which I always really appreciate. Now, we've got a UK socket and USB port on the left-hand side. There is a shelf here as well, and a telephone if you need to contact reception or goodness knows what, housekeeping, room service, who knows. And on the other side, exactly the same as you can see, UK socket, USB port, you can control your lights from here as well, and there is another shelf. Oh, what's this? Oh, the Arena Spa. We might actually head that way a little later. Stay tuned. Oh, whilst I'm pretty much down on my knees, can I just point out there is no storage space under the bed. I repeat, there is no storage space under the bed. We'll see if there's room for your luggage elsewhere. Now then, in the corner, I've got a nice comfy looking chair actually. Good size lamp here with a splash of artwork. Makes it feel a little bit more homely, actually. I do like that. These blinds are absolutely going to keep out the light, aren't they? And over here, apart from travel blog Jamie, now this is interesting. We've got a workspace, or maybe you call this a vanity area. Something that has not actually featured in these rooms before is this espresso machine. And we've got pods down here, look. And it says that if you'd like any fresh milk and towels, I'm not sure what the link is there, to please contact reception. Duly noted. We have complimentary mineral water here, glasses, cups. Oh, these are dinky and so cute, look, for the espresso machine. I like those. Lots of UHT milk. Oh, chocolate chip cookies, golden oat crumbles. We've got coffee, tea there as well. And of course your kettle, because we're in the UK and we cannot survive. We cannot survive without a kettle in our room, or indeed in the cabin on a cruise ship. It just would not work. And you may have noticed there are two UK sockets here plus two USB ports. We've got a good size television over here, and below another UK socket. Let's have a look at some of the storage space. What is this? Ah, that's where we've got, well, another shelf plus also a safe. I say complimentary to use. You've probably paid for it, haven't you, in your overnight stay? And down here, there's another UK socket. Let's have a look at the storage space over here. So I suppose you could leave your luggage on this ledge if you wanted to. There is a cupboard here. I don't think that's anything. Hello? No, that's nothing. Some hanging space here. And somewhere you could put your bags or your shoes. Now then, above this mirror, there is a small cupboard. And below, down on our knees, we have two good-sized drawers, actually. Hairdryer, yes, I will do the hairdryer test. I will risk being sent to A&E for you. And another. Haven't seen a Holy Bible yet, so I can't thank Jesus. Let's check out the other. And this one, as you can see, more hanging space, but actually it's not interrupted by any shelves. So hang your dresses, your robes up here. And of course, we've got an ironing board and an iron. Always much appreciated, actually, when you stay in a hotel. Alrighty, to the left, to the right. No, we're not going right. Here's the bathroom, standard bathroom. Decent size, actually, folks, not bad. There is your toilet for your gorgeous little cheeks. I do like that there is a shelf that runs all the way around this bathroom. So plenty of space for your toiletries. Sink basin, I mean, why am I telling you that? You can see it's a sink basin. And look, you even have running water. Wow. And we have some complimentary products here. Pricha, I don't know how you say that. Shampoo, conditioner, body this, body that, hand wash, body lotion. Awesome. We've got sockets here for your shavers or perhaps your electric toothbrush and shower. Clingy curtains. Look, I'm over clingy curtains. I don't care anymore. Clingy or not, it's a shower. And we've again got some shampoo and shower gel here. This also doubles up as a bath. How fabulous.
All right, time for that hairdryer test. That looks like I'm shooting myself, doesn't it? Probably not get this published now. Time for the, how do you do a hairdryer sign with your hands? I'll just pick it up.
Oh, you cheeky little thing. Now then, this hairdryer has two settings, two speed settings, and three for heat, I believe. Let's go.
Are you ready for this? Setting number one. Two. I tried all three heat settings, and number three, it nearly scalded me. So you're going to be just fine if you've got a lot of hair on that head of yours. Or I should point out, it comes with this funny little attachment. I don't blow dry my hair, so I don't know what you would do with that. Please drop your comments below and tell me exactly what this is for. Thank you. So what do we think? This is a standard king room. I think this is blimmin' good value for £80 for the night. I don't know what you think. Drop your comments below. However, it is time to go explore the rest of this hotel, including the spa and the pool. I feel a swim coming on. Oh, yes. Look what I found.
Here's a look at the wee lobby from above. We are heading to the pool and spa area, which is on M floor, between ground floor and floor one. Here's the Rena Spa.
And of course, you'll want to know what's on offer at the Rena Spa. So here's a look at the brochure. Are you looking for it rough? Maybe gentle? Do you want your nails done? Or what about a Brazilian?
Alrighty, down to the pool we go. Oh, look, everybody who's having refreshments in the conservatory area could, if they wanted to, see you. Now, I've got these gorgeous things on now. Look, let's do this. Oh, it's very quiet. I like this. Oh, hurrah, we've got a hot tub, and this is a really good size one. Look, probably fit about 10 people in that, actually. Okay, we've got a water fountain over here. Towards the end of the pool, there are a number of loungers, tables, nice and comfy. And the pool. Let's check out just how warm that water is in a minute. I think this is a good size pool, actually. And the air temperature in here, it's lovely. You can just literally lie out naked if you really want to. No, don't do that. Please don't do that. Just beneath the stairs, you've got a couple more loungers as well. I'm going to head back up, get changed and check out that bar. Not that I'm an alcoholic or anything, folks. You understand? This is for research purposes. This is all for you. Let your cares drift away. Damn right. We've got a gorgeous seating area right by the changing rooms, and there is also a sauna and steam room. I'm not going to show you inside. There are people in there and I could get thrown in prison.
There are showers available to clean yourself of all that chlorine. You'll need a pound coin for the lockers, and thank you Jesus, there's one of those whizzy things to dry your smalls.
Has anybody else got a stairs fetish, or is it just me? These stairs are just mesmerizing. I love them. Okay, so this is the lobby area. Just to my right, you have reception. We've got some nice comfy areas right in the middle. And as you can see, there's some seating, tables, oh, two very cozy armchairs, and a lovely fire.
Oh my goodness, look at this. There's popcorn that you can help yourself to in reception. Awesome.
I'm presuming you can help yourself to this fruit as well. Just Off the lobby is the Marco Pierre White restaurant, the steakhouse bar and grill. Just have a quick peep in here. I always whisper when I feel like I'm being naughty. Can't see the whole restaurant because of that sign. However, I think you get the idea. We haven't booked in here, actually. It's a little bit pricey, and we're actually heading for an Indian in Southampton tonight. However, I don't want to be remiss. Here's a little peep at the Steakhouse Bar and Grill menu, so you can make your mind up whether you think this is somewhere you would like to eat. To the right of the Marco Pierre White restaurant, we have Leo's, which is the Grand Harbour's bar. This is where I am heading. Oh, now this has actually been refurbed since I was last here about a year or so ago. It looks a lot better. A bit brighter, splashes of colour. They've removed some of the endless booths. This is much nicer, lots more green. This is the conservatory area. They've redone the floor in here as well. Oh, I like it, you know. This is a massive improvement. Oh, wow, it's really different. Just in case I haven't said this, it's really different. It's much more elegant and stylish, actually. And they've done the bar area as well. Fantastic. There is also an outdoor seating area. I'm not going to go out there because it's peeing down with rain, it's dark, they don't have all the furniture out, but take my word for it. Apart from your usual range of wines, beers, ciders, spirits, we have cocktails, and you all know I love a porn star, don't you? The martini type, obviously. Filthy lot.
Cheers, everyone. Savvy Blanc for me tonight. Chin chin. Mmm. Nicely chilled, nice and crisp.
Now, would you look at that? We have room service, Leo's.
Behold, the room service menu. Now then, any item with a 24 next to it doesn't mean it's £24, although it's not all cheap here. It means those items are available 24/7. And look, under Leo's specials, not a huge selection, but those items are available between 12 p.m. and 10 p.m. We've got a couple sides and just the one dessert.
Okay, so the Indian we're eating at tonight, I know this is about the Leonardo, but Cootie's Brasserie is literally a few minutes walk away, and it's an excellent Indian. So I do recommend this if you like your Asian food.
And there you go, folks. That's my tour and review of the Leonardo Royal Southampton. As always, I'd love to hear from you, so please do drop your comments below. Have you stayed? Will you stay? What are your thoughts?
And as always, you know what's coming now, don't you? Don't forget to follow Travel Blog Jamie on Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube.